Praise the Lord. It's good to have you here today with us, to join us live. Amen. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Welcome all the Rock of Zion Church and all those that are following us, liking us, sharing us throughout the internet community. And I appreciate you doing that. The world needs to hear about God. The world needs to hear more that God has a purpose for them and that God's got a plan for them. And thank you for doing that. I just want to encourage all of you that are home right now to go ahead and just turn everything off and just concentrate in this service. Let this message be a blessing to your soul, to your mind, to your spirit, that it can touch you, lift you up in these times of troubles, confusing times, the times when we're trying to find out what's going on in this world. Amen. And but I'm here to bring a message to you. We're here to worship the Lord in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I want to read a scripture before Sister Leanne and Sister Crystal leads us into worship. But first of all, I want to pray. I want to pray for all those that are hurting with the coronavirus. There's many people out in this world that are suffering. I got to see some people out there in Latin America, where there's a lot of things happening over there, and my heart goes out to them. And of course, there's victories in Jesus' name along the road, and the Lord has lifted up our brother Eli Hernandez. Amen. Has touched his soul and his body in Jesus' name. And I am glad that we came behind that and prayed for him to get out of that hospital in the name of Jesus. We plead the blood for him. And also the family here in Moore Park that has been blessed too as well. But there are other people that are suffering. There's other pastors that are suffering too right now. So I want to go before the Lord in the name of Jesus. Will you pray with me? Amen. Let's come together right now in one mind and one accord. Hallelujah. No matter where you're at. Hallelujah. In the car, in your living room, it doesn't matter. Let's join together right now. Lord, you're everything to us. And we come before you, mighty God, in times of darkness, in times of despair, in times of confusion, God, in times of fear, Lord. And I ask you, God, to intervene in this time, in this season, Lord. I ask you, God, that all those people right now that are suffering, God, have compassion towards them, Lord. Deliver them, Lord, from this virus in the name of Jesus Christ, God. You are the only one that can do that, Lord. I pray, God, I plead the blood upon them right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, right now. Every minister's wife, God, Lord, I pray that you will deliver them from this coronavirus, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Nothing's greater than you, Lord. Nothing's impossible, Lord. Hallelujah. Everything is possible with you. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we declare it. We claim it right now in the name of Jesus Christ, God. Hallelujah. And to you be all the glory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't forget, amen, there's many options to give on to the church. I want to leave that open to you. to give unto the church so that the church can continue on in Jesus' name. We're here because we love you. We're here because we want you to be blessed. My daughters are here because they want to bless you, amen, as well as they want to bless the Lord, amen. We're here for one purpose, amen, is to magnify his wonderful and precious name. Hallelujah. Let me read this scripture to you. In the book of Psalms, chapter 113, praise ye the Lord. Praise, O ye servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord from this time forth and forevermore. From the rising of the sun unto the going down of the same, the Lord's name is to be praised. Amen. Hallelujah. Will you praise him with us? Will you lift up your hands towards heaven? Amen. And love him with us as we magnify his wonderful and precious name. Hallelujah. This is a good time to praise him. Hallelujah. And while everybody else is doing something else, amen. But you, my friend, you are praising the Lord in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Yeah. situation that we're all going through. It says, I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of God. No matter what's happening, I want to see the goodness of God. I want to look at that situation and say, but God did this. This may have happened, but did you see what God did in this? Oh, I want to see the goodness of who He is. I want to see Him. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, I worship Him. I give Him all the praise and all of the glory. Hallelujah, Jesus. One thing that we have to remain firm in and confident in is our worship and our praise. We can never let our worship and our praise go away. We can never let it just get put on the back burner. This song says, I raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemies. It may look like a storm around me, but I'm going to lift my hands and I'm going to raise a hallelujah. Hallelujah is 1,000 praises to our God. I'm going to lift Him up. I'm going to worship Him no matter what.
In the middle of the storm, louder and louder, you're not here.
King is alive, amen. We celebrate Him. We celebrate Him being alive. Nothing's gonna take away my praise. Nothing's gonna stop me from praising. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. God's love is more than we can ever even imagine it could be. It's more than you felt from any person, the kind of love that God has for you. Jesus. Right where we're at, can you lift your hands with us? Can we just begin to worship Him right now? God, we give you all the praise, Lord. We give you all the honor, Lord, and all of the glory, mighty God. We want to worship you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. There's no perfect love like his love. For perfect love casteth out all fear. Hallelujah. Amen. What a wonderful thing in Jesus' name. What the world needs is love right now. No doubt. It's always needed love for that matter. Amen. As a matter of fact, God is love and he is the author of love. When you talk about God, you're talking about love. Amen. I want to just for a moment here, I just want to, I want you to pray for all those pastors that are coming into this new journey and social media, trying to catch this perfect view. I want to tell you, If you're a saint of God and your pastor is out there, you know, trying to make it happen, it may not have all the bells and whistles, but I want to tell you something. You need to back up your pastor. You need to pray for them and pray that God will strengthen him during that time. It's not easy preaching to empty seats. It's not easy because every pastor looks forward to seeing the smiling faces every day. I mean, every church service when they come in, shake their hands, shake the brothers, amen. Seeing them run the aisles and jump up and down and praise God, running up on the altar and coming up to the altar and worshiping God. It's a different atmosphere, if I can say, amen. But I can tell you for sure that God, amen, is going to make a way. And keep praying for your pastor, amen. And if you're watching right now, you know, and you have a different pastor, please support him. Support your other pastor, amen. You want to hear the message? That's fine. But I want you to support your own pastor and your own church in Jesus' name. Praise God. Now that I said that, amen. If you like what you see, amen, the songs and the preaching that's about to take place, or you've heard the preaching already, I want you to press like, and I want you to press share. I want you to put that out there so that other people will see this message, amen. There's a lot of hungry people that are looking. And here's the thing. There's a lot of voices out there, amen, but we need to be sensitive to the voice of God in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Well, I'm gonna read you a scripture, and I'm gonna try to lay the foundation here before I start my message. Message entitled "I Will Not Let You Go," and you'll understand once I start reading. Jacob was a young man that deceived his father in a blessing. And so Esau was the one who was supposed to get the blessing. But Jacob and his mother deceived, amen, their father. And so their father blessed the wrong person, as far as we can see. But let's see. Let's catch this moment. Because Jacob, actually the name Jacob, means a deceiver. And so we're going to find right now, I'm going to take you into the setting in which he finds himself in. So in Genesis chapter 32, in verse 18, and you will see that on your screen, amen. "Then you shall say, your servant's Jacob's." It is a present. This is what was happening when he heard that Esau was looking for him with 400 men. And he's kind of figured, I will send some servants. I will try to, kind of soften them up before I go out there and meet him, because I know he's after me and he wants to take vengeance. And so he sent, in verse 18, he said, then you shall say, your servant Jacob, it is a present sent to my lord Esau. Because he was wondering what was going on. He said, what's all these gifts for? And Esau was questioning it. And behold, he also is behind us. And so he commanded the second and the third and all that followed the droves, saying, in this way you shall speak to Esau when you find him. Jacob is telling his servants. And also you shall say, behold, your servant Jacob is behind us. For he said, I will appease him with the present that goes before me, and afterward I will see his face. Perhaps he will accept me. And the present went over before him, and he himself lodged that night in the camp. And he rose up that night and took his two wives and his two slave women and his 11 sons and passed over the ford Jabbok. And he took them and sent them over the stream and sent over what he had. And Jacob was left alone. And a man wrestled there with him until the breaking of the day. And when he saw that he did not prevail against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh. And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And he said, let me go, for the day breaks. And he said, and Jacob answered, said, I will not let you go, except you bless me. Except you bless me. And he said to him, what is your name? And he said, Jacob. And he said, your name shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel. For like a prince, you have power with God and with men, and have prevailed. And Jacob asked and said, I pray ye, reveal your name. And he said, why do you ask after my name? And he blessed him there. And Jacob called the name of the place, Face of God, for I have seen God face to face. And my life is preserved. And as he passed over a Peniel, the sun rose upon him. And he limped upon his thigh. And therefore the sons of Israel do not eat of the sinew of the thigh, which is on the hip socket until this day, because he touched Jacob's hip socket, the sinew of the thigh. Hallelujah. Amen. Lord Jesus, right now, God, where everybody's at, and those that are listening to me right now, the sound of my voice, God, I ask you, Lord, to just go, mighty God, and just touch them right there where they're at right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, release your anointing. Release, mighty God, your word upon them and change them and touch their mind, God, in the name of Jesus. I pray in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Somebody say in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. And so Jacob's return home meant he must meet Esau. He had to meet him. Amen. Because he knew that one day he could not run any further. He had to meet Esau. And despite the divine encouragement, such as a reunion seemed very dangerous for him. Had Esau forgiven him? Maybe not. I don't know. The scripture doesn't say he forgave him before he was looking for him. Would he seize the chance to kill Jacob? Maybe. Maybe he would have seized the moment. But Jacob was having no chance. That's why he sent his people before him so that he could soften them up with presents and things that he could actually soften his brother. And these were the anxieties, the uppermost in Jacob's mind as he returned. And all his actions were designed to soften the greater encounter. Hallelujah. And so That's one of the things that we as people, amen, we tend to run from things, from our problems, from situations. Some people do not want confrontations. They don't want to deal with it. And the matter just gets worse and worse. But I want to help you today, amen, where I can show you, hallelujah, through the scripture, amen, amen, and by the anointing of the word, hallelujah, that you may understand, amen, that there's a time to let go and there's a time not to let go until God blesses us. Hallelujah. Praise God. You may run from your problems or the sin that you committed that eventually you will have to face them and confront them. And facing your circumstances will make you a better man and a better woman in Jesus' name. But facing them is not really the hard part. The hard part is when you understand that you do have to face them and you must stop running. Can I tell you this? I've known a lot of backsliders, and as a matter of fact, if we got all the backsliders to come back to church, I guarantee you we would not be able to fill the church. I mean, we couldn't contain them in the churches. Amen. Hallelujah. I want so many souls unto the Lord. We would have this place packed here today in Jesus' name. But quit running from God. It's time to face your sins, to face your problems, amen, and change those while you have the chance in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Knowing what to do and not doing it can be the most challenging thing in anybody's life. It is very hard. Hallelujah. But here's the thing. We have to stop running, amen, from facing that thing that has kept you from gaining the victory. Hallelujah. You have to understand that the Lord wants to give you the victory. He wants to give you the promises. He wants to bless your life. Stop running from God. Hallelujah. Amen. It may be brokenness. I don't know. It may be forgiveness. Maybe you got to forgive your brother, your mother, your sister, your uncle, whoever it is. And it's been challenging you all this time. It's keeping you from God. Hallelujah. Praise God. And lying, amen, that maybe God will help you. Hallelujah. Then the preparation of it all, everything about you must change once you decide that. Everything must change. Your attitude, your spirit must change. Your emotions, your thinking, hallelujah, the way you perceive things must change. Because once you realize that you got to face the problem, that you know, regardless of the circumstances, regardless of what's there, you face the problems. You say, God, I'm putting it in your hand, and I'm going to put it right in front of you so that you can take care of it. And I guarantee you, my friend, that God will take care of it when you give it to him. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. I remember that before, when back at BC, which means before Christ, when I was in the world, if I would go to court, I would definitely want some kind of a request, and I wanted my request already known to myself, and I wanted to put it out there unto the judge. Hallelujah. Before, let me tell you this, before you challenge anybody or anything, you must see yourself as the victor. As a matter of fact, let me put it this way to you. When I got into this thing, Christianity at the time, I didn't get in to lose. I got in it to win. Hallelujah. I got in it because I knew, hallelujah, I had read the back of the book, and we are winners. Hallelujah. We are more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. And so when I play in a team or whatever, I plan to win. I don't plan to lose. Listen, friend of mine, hallelujah, I can tell you one thing, that if you're not living for God, you're not on the winning side. But the moment you start living for God, you are in the winning side. Hallelujah. Praise God. When people get dragged down, it feels almost impossible. But let me just give you this. An arrow can only be shot by pulling it backwards. When life is dragging you back with difficulties, and it means that it's going to launch you, amen, into something great. So just focus, amen, on, and keep aiming in the direction that you're going. Hallelujah. Praise God. God is going to launch you into something better today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Don't worry about the circumstances around. Listen, you're probably wondering, how am I going to pay my bills? How am I going to do this? Hang on. Hallelujah. God is on his way. Hallelujah. God is going to make a way, and he's bringing you back. Hallelujah. And he's going to launch you deeper into the things of God. Hallelujah. People run from things that they don't want to face, and they wrestle within themselves. The mind is the first place they wrestle in. They try to figure it all out. They try to put it all together in one place, and they try to put it in a package of how they think it should go. And all of a sudden, God comes in there and throws everything out of the way and says, that's not how I'm going to do it. Get that out of the way. Let me take care of you. Hallelujah. Somebody's going to come by and drop some money in your house. Somebody's going to stop by and bless you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I've seen men wrestle right here in this altar, right here where I'm at today, and even before. I've seen men, grown men, a burly man that come to the altar, hallelujah, struggling with life, struggling with divorces, struggling with marriage and relationships. And these men that seem that they would never cry, all of a sudden, something begins to break down on them. Something begins to just get a hold of them. And they bend their rugged body into the floor and bend their knees, and they begin to call out on God. And God begins to touch them and move upon them. And I guarantee you, amen, that if you do that today, right where you're at, right where you're living room, God, hallelujah, will bless you. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When you are in the arena wrestling for your life, you will quickly know that nobody plays fair. Nobody plays fair. They're all out for themselves, and they're going to try, amen, to run over you whatever way they can. But I want to tell you something, church, friend of mine, hallelujah. I want to tell you that God, hallelujah, knows what's going on in your life. He knows exactly what's happening right now, and God is going to make a way for you. You cannot, listen, friend of mine, you cannot send somebody else to win your victory. You yourself has to stand up. I'm going to tell you, it has brought the best out of many people in this situation. It has brought the worst in people in this situation, of what's going on in this world. But I pray, hallelujah, that it's brought the very best out of you today. That somehow you'll find yourself, amen, I'm a man, but you know what? A man can cry unto the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm a single parent. I'm a woman trying to take care of my kids. God, help me right now. Hallelujah. I'm talking about touching God and not letting go. Hallelujah. You can say, please, hallelujah, tell Tom that I said this. Tell Jill that I said that. No, you got to do it yourself. You got to face the music. You got to face the consequences. Hallelujah. Amen. Facing these things will bring emotions. Yes, it will. You'll get nervous. You'll start sweating, and you'll shake a little bit, and you may stutter a little bit. Your stomach will feel like you got a bunch of butterflies. But once you get it out of the way, I'm telling you, hallelujah, that it's gonna be okay. Listen, most of you have struggled in life. Maybe this is probably the worst struggle that you've ever struggled in. But the struggle is not to destroy you. I said the struggle is not there to destroy you. Nuh-uh, it's far from that. The struggle is not there to beat you down and destroy you. But it's to help you gain strength. To possess the promises of God. God's already given you. Those struggles are there for a reason in our life. Hallelujah. What are those promises? Well, they are the promises of salvation. Hallelujah. He said, I will never leave you or forsake you. I will be with you until the end of the world. Hallelujah. Amen. For some of us, maybe some of you, you may feel that it's the end of the world. But I want to tell you something. I wish that you could really take that literally for a moment. And maybe you can call me and say, Pastor Roe, I need to get right with God. I need to get baptized in your wonderful name of Jesus. I need to be filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost. It's been a long time since I touched God. It's been a long time since I talked to him in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Jesus. Amen. God has brought us to a place, a divine anointing, a divine change, hallelujah, divine empowerment in order for us to receive into our lives the fulfillment of the promises of God. We must first endure the struggle that lasts all night long and leaves us broken and weary and sore. It may hurt. It may hurt for a moment. Just like any man that tries to win a race. Oh, the struggle that he tries to prepare to win the race. The man that begins to lift weights. The weights, maybe some weights that are not that heavy, begin to feel very heavy. But after a while, those weights begin to feel like nothing. Hallelujah, Jesus. But when we come out on the other side, hallelujah, when we come out on the other side of the night, it will be good. I said, this will not last forever. Hallelujah. There's going to be an open door, and then we're all going to come out, and we're all going to find a place where we can come to church. Hallelujah. You'll grab your family. You'll grab your sister. You'll grab your brother. You'll call us and say, I want to go to church. Hallelujah. Praise God. When the weeping of the night gives way to the joy of the morning. I know. Listen, I've been there. I've done that. When it seems like it's dark on both sides and it seems like it's falling all apart, God always makes a way. Hallelujah. I've prayed up all night long and asking God to help me and give me strength. But I thank the Lord for that in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus, for being there. He's been tested and proven, amen, to be able, hallelujah, to give us what we need. And we will find that we have been changed forevermore, that we have been endued with power from on high. Hallelujah. But first, the struggle. Oh, Jacob, you were struggling all this time. Oh, Jacob, you were running from your brother. And you realized that you could not run anymore. And there you are, Jacob, trying to find a solution to your problem. Listen, don't curse the struggle. Don't curse the struggle. There is strength in the struggle. Don't curse the persecution. There's power in persecution. Amen. I heard somebody say, what can't kill you will strengthen you. You'd be surprised what you can take. You'd be surprised what you can endure. You should be surprised how long you can actually stay on your knees and pray unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. What a beautiful thing. Amen. Albert Einstein said this, the significant problems we face cannot be solved at the same level of thinking. We cannot be solved at the same level of thinking we were at when we created them. This problems in your life that's been created, amen, cannot be resolved in the same level. God says you need to go to the next level of your life. You need to jump above that, amen, and get the solution. Get it taken care of, amen. You cannot be where you were before. You got to get up higher, amen, so God can take care of that problem. Amen, amen. Problems. Let me tell you something. Problems are always the doorway to the next level of growth. It is. They're always the door to the next level of growth. I thank God. As a matter of fact, Paul says, I rejoice in my tribulation. Hallelujah. I never thought about that when I was going through some trials and tribulation. I don't ask for the trials. I don't ask for the tribulations. Amen. But I know that if I rejoice, like Paul said, amen, the tribulations will only, amen, make me stronger in the Lord. Hallelujah. And here's the thing. When I am weak, he is strong. So you say, well, I feel weak right now, Pastor Rojo. I feel down right now. Well, listen, even David went to the battle to fight an army came back to his village, to his town, and all the soldiers had come back, and the enemy has stolen their wives and their children, and the men of David wanted to kill him. And David turned around and went to his tent, and he strengthened himself in the Lord. It means that he went before God and began to pray and ask God for direction. Maybe that's what you need to do, is ask God for direction today. Hallelujah, Jesus. Because when you are challenged in life, how can you send someone else if the challenge was with you? Hallelujah, Jesus. Amen. In order for any of us to feel the thrill of victory, I've always said this, amen. You got to accept the challenge. You got to accept the challenge. Amen. Too many people don't want the challenge because they're afraid. They're afraid to leave what they were doing. Every day of our lives will be challenging, but the moment you feel fear, you will lose. You will lose. And can I tell you, friend of mine, hallelujah, can I tell you this? God is not the author of fear. And there's a lot of people fearing all over the place. Hallelujah. But I want to tell you that you need to get a hold of God. Let the love of God that casteth all, amen, fear in Jesus' name. Let me tell you what Patrick Henry wrote in 1775, amen. He said this, it is in vain, sir, to extenuate, means to lessen the matter. Gentlemen may cry, peace, peace, but there's no peace. The war is actually begun, he said. The next gale that sweeps from the north will bring to our ears the clash of resounding arms. Our brethren are already in the field. Why stand we here idle, he says. What is it that gentlemen wish? What would they have? Is life so dear? Or peace so sweet as to be purchased at the price of chains and slavery? He says, forbid it. This is a man back in the day, 1775. He said, forbid it. Almighty God, he claims. I know not what course others may take. But as for me, he said, give me liberty or give me death. Hallelujah. So I ask you today, amen, hallelujah. Will you live for God or take death? Because living for God is liberty. In 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7 says this. This is from the contemporary English version. He says this, God's Spirit, now watch this, God's Spirit doesn't make cowards out of us. Hallelujah. Amen, amen. I'm not talking about physical fighting, because if that was the case, we'd be victorious in Jesus' name. But God said, we fight on our knees. We fight with the word of God. Listen, God fights for us. Hallelujah, amen. The Spirit gives us power and love and self-control. Somebody say amen. Let me share with you this today, the before and after Jacob. Before the struggle, Jacob relied on his own strength. And that's how we were when everything was good and all of a sudden our strength was taken away and now we have to depend on God. And, you know, I really believe that God is saying you depended too much on the things that are around you. And now you have to really depend on me. How are you going to survive? God says, why don't you lean on me now? We've heard many, many scriptures, trust in the Lord. Faith, have faith in the Lord. But now, hallelujah, when the rubber meets the road, hallelujah, we need to prove that we must trust in God and have faith in God and pray unto a God that is alive and well and moving in us and around us and making the world, amen, to come to a standstill to get our attention in Jesus' name. If he went into the struggle strong, complete within himself, but during the struggle, God smote Jacob's thigh. And this is significant because God said, if I am to be strong in you, your strength has to shrink. I must decrease so he can increase. His strength is made perfect in weakness. Amen. After the struggles, his strength was diminished, but God was increased. And before the struggle, Jacob went into the encounter, which was a deceiver and a serpenter. Maybe what you were, you don't like what you were. But God can change that. In the struggle, his name was changed to Israel because God said, "For as a prince hast thou power with God and with men has prevailed." Hallelujah. Oh my. Hallelujah. Somebody say amen. The power is in the struggle. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Let me tell you something. I struggled to get to God. I struggled in my life. Amen. But it was because of that, hallelujah, that I went into a Pentecostal church house, and that's where God touched me. When I stopped relying on the arm of flesh and put my total trust in God, I gained power. Somebody say amen. It's the struggle that produces the strength. And I need to overcome and prevail in my life, just like you need to overcome and prevail in your life. After the struggle, his name was Israel, which means power. Strength, listen, strength is never, never in comfort. Strength is born in struggle. And when we pray for God to strengthen us, we must realize that strength is going to come through a face-to-face encounter with the Almighty God. Hallelujah. And during which we will probably be smitten. Hallelujah. God might allow things to happen to us. An example was Job. Amen. Hallelujah. God took everything from him. And all of a sudden, Job learned. Amen. Got closer to God because of the struggle that he went through. Hallelujah. God double blessed him. Amen. His fruits were multiplied. Hallelujah. And God made an example of how you can get blessed by trusting in God. Somebody say amen. Amen and fight. Amen. But when we come through the struggle, we're going to have something much more awesome than an uncrippled leg. We're going to have a new name. Somebody say a new name. When all of this is done and over, because it will end. All this stuff that we're seeing, it will end. It will come out, amen, with a new relationship, a new perspective, a new love for God. Hallelujah, amen. We're going to have power we never had before, an awakening to the church, and understand, amen, that you are the church. You have the power in the name of Jesus. We're going to have confidence and trust in God that we never had. At best of all, we're going to see God face to face. You see, the effect of God's gift should not result in cowardice, but power. Of three characteristics of God's gift, power is the ability to accomplish what God wants. Love is the focus of and end result of power. And self-discipline is sound judgment to know how to combine power with love in time of crisis. That's what we need to do. Maybe this is the time to find love in the time of crisis in your life. Paul urged Timothy to think about who was with him. Amen. Then he urged him to think about what he was going to do in the world. You can never become anything when you live in the corner. You may ask, I just don't know what happened if I give myself wholly unto the Lord. There's a lot of things that could happen. Your life will change. Amen. I'm going to tell you, that's fear, and fear opens the door to many things that will hold us from living for God to the fullest. This is what happens when fear comes. It causes others to lose their lives. What do you mean, Pastor Rojo? I'll tell you what I mean. When fear takes over a soldier, he can cause other soldiers to die. And what I mean is this. If you are always fearing of what you don't know, then you will never have anybody following you. There are some times that you will take a step and you will not know, amen, that what's going to happen. And sometimes you got to take a step of faith in your life. Look at what happened to Jacob. Jacob did, amen, did before his change. Before he changed, he sent his family, risking his family that might die in the encounter. Why? Because of his fear to himself. He sent a delegation to make contact, amen, and then returned with alarming news that Esau was on his way with 400 men. They did not say whether the men were hostile or not, but Jacob feared the worst. And Jacob was anointed and commissioned man of God in spite, amen, of his shortcomings and failures. God has still had a purpose for him. Somebody say amen. But the fact that Jacob was promised blessing and direction didn't automatically guarantee his success. He never laid hold of the promises of God until after he endured a struggle that lasted all night long and left him broken. Hallelujah, Jesus. I want to just bring to your attention here, amen, that here was Jacob. Jacob really wanted an answer. He found himself face to face with God. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. And Jacob here, he doesn't know the outcome of what's going to happen. He doesn't know what's going to take place. But one thing he does, he goes before God. He goes over the brook, amen, to Jabbok, amen. And he wants to find an answer from God. And can I tell you, church, that right now, hallelujah, God is saying, you need to wait on me, hallelujah. And here's what happened to Jacob. He walked over across the brook, amen, and then he began to wrestle with a man there. Jacob didn't know what was going to happen. But one thing that I've learned from myself in my past, in my life, is that I've gone before the Lord. And I say, God, I'm not leaving this place. I'm not leaving this, my office. I'm not leaving this place where I'm kneeling down right now until I feel the release from you. Until I feel your anointing upon me. I spend hours, almost all night through the breaking of the day with God. I say, God, you need to help me in this time. And I'll tell you that too many times, amen, men and women go before God and they leave too early before God can even touch them, before God can ever do anything in their lives. I'll tell you, hallelujah, we pray a little prayer, amen, that may change a little bit of your conscience, amen. But really, God is looking for a prayer that can change, completely transform you and can touch the heavens, hallelujah, and His mighty hand will come down in your life and help you. You need to let go. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, amen. Let go of your flesh. I mean, it takes us at least 45 minutes just to get past the flesh. Jacob said, I will not let you go. I don't want to let you go because I want you to bless me. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Maybe you're contemplating right now and say, God, you need to tell God, say, God, don't let me go. I'm not letting you go, Lord, until you bless me, until I know that your spirit is upon me, God. Hallelujah. Jacob held on to him. Jacob held on to him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. It reminds me of that day in that Pentecostal church house. I say, God, I'm not leaving this place. I'm not leaving this place until you bless me. I'm not going back to what I was. I need a change in my life. I've been running to and fro from hell and back, God. Hallelujah. And I need a word. I need deliverance from this heroin and cocaine. Hallelujah, Jesus. And all of a sudden, amen, I said, I'm not going to let you go, Lord. I remember very clear, hallelujah, as it was yesterday. There was a man standing next to me saying, it was kind of funny. But I see why now. Somebody was saying, hold on, brother. And the other brother on the right side was saying, let go. Hallelujah. But somewhere inside of me, I wanted to reach to God. I wanted to touch Him. What I was feeling was much more, hallelujah, than I'd ever felt. Many better than drugs, better than alcohol, better than one night stands, in Jesus' name. And there was God looking down from the balcony of heaven. He says, I'm coming down to you, son. I'm going to help you. hallelujah, and he came down, hallelujah, and touched my very soul, hallelujah, and all of a sudden, rivers of living water began to flow from my spirit. I didn't know what it was. I never experienced it. I didn't know what Pentecost was, but all of a sudden, the Spirit of God was upon me. Oh, hallelujah. And when I say, God, I will not let you go until you bless me. Maybe friend of mine, sinner friend of mine, maybe Christian friend of mine that's backslidden, hallelujah. Maybe you need to just get down on your knees wherever you're at and talk to God and tell him, Lord, hallelujah, I've been far from God, hallelujah. Even the words, Jesus, does not come out of my lips. And God says, if you get a hold of me, hallelujah, and touch me and hold on to me until I bless you, hallelujah, I'm telling you right now, friend of mine, you can do it. My Lord, hallelujah. Amen. I still remember it. Amen. The Holy Ghost came. I began to speak in this beautiful language. Hallelujah. I didn't know what it was. I didn't understand it. But I'll tell you what. I felt power within me. I felt deliverance within me. Hallelujah. But most of all, I felt the love of God caressed me. Hallelujah. And I knew that I had been with God. I knew that I had seen God. God, face to face, just like Jacob was. Hallelujah. Now watch this. When Jacob said, bless me, and the angel, amen, said, he said, what is your name? He said, my name is Jacob. And the Lord said, your name shall no longer be Jacob. It will be Israel, the prince amen of Israel. Hallelujah. He says, you will no longer be that Jacob anymore. In other words, that Jacob, that supplanter, the deceiver, no longer exists anymore. For I have touched you. I've touched the hollow of your thigh. And I have changed you. And forever, Jacob, you will know that I've touched you. Because you will walk different. You will talk different. Hallelujah. And that's what it was to me. Hallelujah. When God touched me, I talk different. I walk different. I thought different. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. My. I feel the Holy Ghost right now. You, my friend, wherever you're at, I'm telling you that you can get right with God. He said, but man, I want what that man has. Yes, you can have it. Don't let nobody lie to you that you can't have it. You can have it today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And watch this. Watch this. Hallelujah. Jacob walked out of there walking different. He had to cross the brook. He had to cross the water. To me, that's symbolic. Amen. Because it was crossing, amen, the water. And I'm telling you, water has a significance. And I'll tell you, when the Lord said to me, Francisco, you will no longer be called a drug addict. You will no longer called an alcoholic. You will no longer be a fornicator, an adulterer. You will no longer be called those names. Hallelujah. You will never call a prisoner. Hallelujah. For today, Francisco, son of mine, your name shall be called Francisco Rojo Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, I've never been the same. I've been this way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Erratically saved. Hallelujah. I remember when I went back to Yuma, Arizona, and God had changed me because that's where my life spiraled out of control. I went back and my old friends, I went back to a funeral and they were looking at me and they were saying, is that Francisco? I had long hair back then. And they used to call me Cisco. Is that Cisco? And they come up to me and says, is that you, Cisco? Well, I said, no, that's not Cisco anymore. It's Francisco Rojo Jesus, I said. He looked at me and said, no, no way. He's got to be in there. And he was playing around. He was trying to open up my shirt. He said, he's got to be in there. I go, no, 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 no. That man is dead. That man is dead. Hallelujah. I am forever changed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Jesus. Jacob was forever changed. And the man that he thought was going to kill him, the man that he thought was going to destroy him because he had deceived him, he started walking back. He started walking back towards his brother. And as his brother seen him from afar off, hallelujah, Esau wept and hugged his brother because God had already taken control of the situation. Hallelujah. Oh, God. I say, Lord, how many people are out there struggling? And they blame you, Lord. They struggle and they fall to the knees. Hallelujah. Lord, I pray that they will find strength in you, that they will find a way with you, God, in Jesus' name. Oh, God, help us in this time. Help us find you. Lord, you put everything on a standstill. You put the brakes on everything. They say, let's see if my backsliders will come. Let's see if those that had made promises to me will come. Let's see if those that said I'll pray and never prayed. Let's see if those that said I will go to church will come to church. And I thank God right now that God has made a way for me. My love for him is beyond what I can even express with words. My love for him, hallelujah. This is a time, listen, history shows us that in time, in the history of the Bible, in the hard times, preachers, prophets got behind the pulpits and asked the world to repent, asked their people to repent. And I can see why now. I can see why God says, if my people, amen, which are called by my name, listen, you are Jesus' name. It's time to come home. Jacob went. He grabbed onto his brother. What a beautiful reunion. Oh, my Lord. My Lord, hallelujah, Jesus. I've been bouncing back all my life with half brothers and half sisters all the time. But I have never felt the greatest love like my Father, which is in heaven. Hallelujah, Jesus. And I'll tell you, the love that I have within the saints of God is totally different. I can't explain that to you. It's different. It's different. And I tell you that it changed me from a brawler. I'm not caring. And I remember that time when I was up in the fishing on the boat and I was in the stern of the boat. And I looked in the eye, I looked at land. And as the land was, lights were dimming down, hallelujah. God said, you can run from your problems. But when you get back on land, there will still be there. And I say, God, I cannot run anymore. Hallelujah, Jesus. And I'm asking you right now, my friend, right now, where you're at. Say, God, forgive me of all my sins right now. Forgive me, Lord, of everything. Forgive me. God can fill you with the Holy Ghost right there and then, right now. In the name of Jesus, I want you to lift up your hands right there and say, God, I'm nothing without you. I'm nothing. Help me right now, God. I want to get closer to you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I praise you. I praise you. I want you to pray right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to thank you for joining us and being with us in this service. I pray that somehow this message has blessed you, has encouraged you through the struggles. And I know that there's some struggles out there in this life. People call me and let me know. But I want to tell you that if you just grab on to the Lord, God's going to help you. This is a good time. It's the greatest time for the church. It's the greatest time for man to come to God. And so I want you to share this. I want you to share this video. Press like and share to all those that you think that might need this. In Jesus' name, I'm here for you. I want to help you. Help you through the struggles. Say, Pastor Rojo, I've never been baptized. Well, I can baptize you too. In the name of Jesus Christ. Text me. Email me. Through my webpage. And just tell me what you want me to pray for. Hallelujah. So next Tuesday, we're going to have a Bible study. Amen. It's a little different. Amen. I'll try to slow down. Amen. We'll try to bring a little more word. And then also Wednesdays and Thursdays, I will be teaching Search for Truth, which will, this is a Bible study for beginners that never actually walked through the Bible. This will give you an insight as to what we have in the Bible. Amen. So this will help you to understand the scripture a little bit. And so I am looking forward to this coming Sunday for Easter. And we're going to be posting more things for Easter, coming Easter. So stand by. Subscribe to YouTube. Amen. And be ready for this coming next Sunday. We want you to just participate in everything that we're going to promote. In Jesus' name. For the church, share in Jesus' name. God bless you. I love you all. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, God bless you.